Hello everyone, welcome to the Trap Conca Verde here in Lonato, Italy. It's our last final of our last day here at the IWSF Shotgun World Championships, and it's the junior men's skeet that wraps up our week here. Six young men ready to show they will be around for a while, and perhaps hoping to emulate Dustin Perry, our American co-commentator, who was competing in the senior event and had a pretty good competition. But our focus now is on these young men in the skeet final, and a big time for them, a big moment.
Big moment, you know, you never know what's going to happen with these juniors, but it's a big opportunity for them to cement themselves kind of in the world, especially here at World Championships.
Well, let's meet them. Waste no time getting to see these youngsters. They do look so young, don't they? And this is perhaps the youngest in the field, 17 years of age. He top qualifying, 124 out of 125, which is excellent. Itu Kallionen of Finland. Well, we were talking, weren't we, Dustin, about the factory that is the United States shooting team. And here's another product, Philip Youngman, last year as a junior, bronze last year in the Junior World Championships.
And it won't be long, and Philip will be competing in the senior category. He is a very good talent, and just a matter of time for him.
And there's one of two Italians in the final, Christian Sigotti, 18 years of age. And this is a man who's done quite a lot on the junior stage, the Cypriot, Nicholas Basilio. Gold in Larnaca on home turf in 2012, a silver in Seoul in 2013, and a bronze in Maribor last year. So he is certainly very, very experienced. Here's the other Italian, big smile from Valerio Paolucci. And finishing up here, our sixth athlete from France, 19 years of age, 19th in the European Championships a couple of years ago, his best, so a really good effort by him, Dylan Choret of France. So those are our six, two Italians, and the home fans will be hoping that will be a chance for some more medals. Saw a medal in the senior, of course. A bronze medal for Gabriella Rossetti. So what can we see here? Sun, as you can see, just about going down. Little peek out behind the clouds.
And the juniors, they have a tougher lighting situation, as it is significantly darker than when the open shot just a few minutes ago.
And the bugs are out all around, the flies and the little bugs, and that's off-putting as well. Here's Itu Kallionen. What a qualifying he had. I think your expression, Dustin, was it was a monster qualification.
It was, especially in the junior category. You don't expect to see that. And that's a world-class number in any circumstances.
Well, he starts well. Starts with intent. A reminder, if you're new to skeet, semi-final, 16 targets shot in sections of four. You've just seen two sets of doubles, and not as many stations as you see in qualification. They go all around the semicircle, eight stations in total, and then of course up by where the trap guys, the targets are released there, they have to shoot from that eighth place. It's fascinating watching qualification, and we're hoping that this will be a fascinating semi-final as well. Good work from Philip Youngman.
Todd likes that one.
Well, he has a lot of work to do, does Todd. He's very often sat in the coach's seat for semi-finals here in the shotgun range.
He is. He'd much rather be in that seat than any other else, though.
I did see him the other day and I said, well, did you get medal bonuses because you'd be doing well? I'm not sure that's the case, but
if it's not, he wish he did.
It's not just the coaching, it's even with the juniors in particular, it's remember to set your alarm clock, remember to put it somewhere away from where your bed is, because you need to get up and get the bus. So, and there's our first miss of this semi-final from the Italian. Now, here's the man who has the most experience out of everybody here, a full set of medals, gold, silver and bronze in junior championships. There'll be another medal here for Basilio of Cyprus, just 18 years of age. And Cyprus, a mad country for shooting. And
yeah, they love the sport over there.
Yeah, not just the targets, but they like to get out and about, and a lot of the population. It's permitted in certain windows of the year, allowed to go out hunting, they will do as well. So that's why they have a very good representation in the shotgun disciplines. Now then, Richie must be sweating in all that gear. Goodness me. You'd think it was a cold old day, wouldn't you, in Lenato? I can assure you it's not.
It's a very uncommon stance. You don't see that a lot in today's shooting. You know, he's very squatted down. Not many other shooters can shoot that way, but obviously he could do it pretty well.
Shot eight, last man up. Sixth out of six semi-finalists.
Good qualifier for him, 121.
Ooh, was that a miss? It was. The last one out of the four. That'll be disappointing for him and his coach, but still three quarters of this semi-final to go. This is how it looks after the first station. Youngman and Kalyonen, the American, the Finn, and of course Vasilio of Cyprus. They have a perfect score. And then Shorey, Shikoti and Palmucci with just the one miss. It's still very much anyone's semi-final.
This ought to come down to the wire, especially. See if any of these athletes can kind of pull away.
That's half your team.
Yeah, there's some coaches and physios made the highlight reel there.
It's a tough old job being a physio, isn't it?
It is, it is. They keep us going, though. I don't know what we'd do with that.
That right shoulder, if you're a right-hander, of course, takes an absolute pounding, doesn't it?
It does, it does.
You see it both here and in the indoor disciplines as well. Physio everywhere, any corner they can find. Oh, and there's the first miss from the Finn.
It's actually a little surprising. If I figured if he'd miss one, it'd be on one of the reverse pairs, but surprised to see him give one up here on a pair that he shot through the qualifier.
Chance for Youngman just to edge ahead.
Me and Philip are from the same area, go to the same school, and been training together, and he has been on fire. I mean, it's...
He is shooting very well. Yeah, and you were saying you've got your own range on the farm.
Is that right? My own range on the farm, but while I'm at college, Philip is one of the other athletes that I train with.
And it's a lot of athletes. Which is your college?
Texas A&M University.
And you were saying a lot of people here, junior and senior ranks, either at college or former students.
Yeah, it's kind of crazy that four out of our six skeet men that we brought for this World Championships. All goes to Texas A&M.
There you go. A hot house of shotgun shooting. And another miss there from Shikoti. And then Asilio, a chance to match Youngman to make an 8 out of 8. He looks confident, doesn't he?
He does. You know, you don't see a lot of the juniors able to stack a pair up and shoot it as quick as he did. But, he seems to be very successful with it and can really move the gun.
To say, he knows what it's like to be in finals. He's been in three European Championship finals. I think I might say they were World Championship finals. So he has gold, silver, and bronze in the European Championship at junior level. And last year in the World Championships, he was ninth. So a lot of experience. And Palmucci, well. Another 18-year-old. You have to be under 21 in the year you're competing. And so they'll get another year, that's for sure, and nonchalant walk away. That's what we like to see as well. Let others see how confident you are.
Ooh. That a
double miss. Goodness me. Well, it's not going the way of the Frenchman at the moment. Chauray's struggling.
Kind of got back on track there and getting that pair. Maybe he can find a groove. And
well, he's only a couple off of the possibility of being in a bronze medal match. This is a confirmation of Youngman and Vasilio of Cyprus, both yet to miss. And Kalyonen and Palmucci in the bronze medal places at the moment, but Ciccotti of Italy might have something to say about that. And, well, Shore, if he can get his act together and have a very, very good second half of this match, you never know.
Never know. Anything can happen in this game, especially with the lighting the way it is. The targets are getting really hard to see.
There's somebody who's got his future written on his T-shirt, and who knows, maybe the future of shooting. A lot of Italian families come up to watch this shooting.
Ooh,
and a double miss from Kaljonen.
Wow.
Well, this is the man who shot and only missed one in qualification. He's missed three in this semi-final.
And
a bird coming through.
Oh, he got a little break there.
I think the referee called that, didn't it? So that would have been a really tough one to have to shoot.
That would have. That was amazing concentration to stay focused and still break the first target.
Well done. Excellent work. Well, in the old days, very old days, that used to be the way they used to shoot. They used to actually shoot the birds.
Yeah.
That's the reason they're called birds. But that's a foolish course to take for that particular feathered friend of ours.
Oh!
You see the counting down. Have to get the two pairs away. No messing around. It's getting a little darker now. You can see that counting down really quite brightly in the corner of your eye, if you're up there at the shooting position.
Ooh.
And a miss for Jungmann. Flag goes up from the referee.
You can see the disappointment in his face there, but as long as he regroups and stay focused, anything can happen for him.
Excellent work from Ciccotti. Back on it. There'll be a few more twists and turns before we get to the end of this semi-final, that's for sure.
A lot of shooting left to be done here. Ooh. Misses one there and
on to nine. Still certainly not out of it. It might be very close. You never rule out a shoot-off in these situations, of course. Here's Nicholas Vassilio from Cyprus, who is proceeding serenely on his own in terms of not having missed anything.
You could see that confidence, and he's been here. You said he's shot in three
European championships, yeah, absolutely. And you can't bring that experience, can you?
Oh,
well, there you go, double miss. Me and my commentator's curse.
I did not see that one coming, very surprised. But opens the door for the other athletes to make a run here and maybe get in that gold medal match.
It may be down to experience, but you think the conditions possibly. It's hard to explain when something gets a double miss.
It is, it's hard, and especially if you miss that first one. It could be anything from a gun mount to just not seeing it and then coming back and trying to make things right to get that second target.
There's another miss from the Italian, who is now alongside Vassilio on 10 points. Jungmann just ahead on 11. Shore, and we said, if he can just get a run together, you never know. Never know.
Yeah, after the missing here on station 5, he's right back in the hunt.
Certainly could be if he gets it to two. Spoke too soon, I'm going to say, in a shoot-off for a bronze medal match. He's still one adrift of that at the moment. And the coach, philosophical little, that's all he can do, is a little gesture to say, keep going. He is at the bottom with 8 points. And you see Jungmann on 11, Palmucci and Vassilio on 10. And then just behind them, not far behind, Ciccotti and Kaljonen, who was, before that miss, that double miss, was one of our leaders. There's some of our officials on that far side, our jury members. Referee today, by the way, Sergio Bonifazio of Italy. Jury member Rafael Molinedo of Cuba.
Have the whole world represented with that crew.
Well, our referees have come from all around the world, like our athletes. So here we go then, with our last four shots. Two sets of doubles. Kaljonen, if he can just bag these two. He's in with a shank, but he's missed again. Oh dear. Well, a ripple from the crowd. The man who shot so well in qualification has just had a little, and he was doing so well as well, had a little blip, and that may cost him dear. May cost him a place in a bronze medal match. We don't know yet. It's not done and dusted. Here's Jungmann.
Oh!
Good loud shadow pull.
Good pair for Philip.
This is gathering gloom. Looking out of the cloud, it's not helping. Quite dark cloud. Let's hope we don't get any rain until at least after we've finished this gold medal match. Yeah.
Nice. So Phillip's in the gold medal match and guaranteed a medal.
Yeah,
you can see the sigh of relief on that.
Another good semi-final for the Americans. It'll be a good for the Italians. They have to here, of course. Nice finish. Would be nice for Sicotti. Can he get 13?
And another one.
Yeah, another one that got away from him. So he is on 12 along with Kalionen, the Finn.
And I think the lighting is really getting to these athletes now. If you look at their qualification scores, they just haven't missed this, and now it's getting hard to see out here.
Yeah, it's not quite as dark as it was for the trap on the first of the junior. It was really dark when the scoreboards changed color. It was like we were bathed in a floodlight. Now, Vasilio, just that double miss that's blotted his copybook so far, but this would be enough to put him into the gold medal match.
Nice pair.
Excellently done. And, perhaps he's just got that out of his system, and if he still gets into the gold medal match, then he will be happy with that. In fact, I may have spoken too soon, because Palmucci is on 10. He has a chance to get to 14 as well, so we might have a shoot-off for the gold medal match. It all depends on these two. He probably knows it as well. Big cheer. And yes, he is tied with the Cypriot. And you say, Dustin, it was a very unusual sort of stance, but it works for him.
It's more of the older style if you look back. And it's our coach, Todd, he used to shoot with a very similar stance to that.
You have to remind him of the old style. So, if he can get this here, Sharon could be in a shoot-off. The bronze medal. Well, there you go. We have a five-way shoot-off.
Wow.
Which is astonishing. So, very interesting. Vasilio and Palmucci for the gold medal match. I think we'll have to shoot off to find out who goes there. And then we will also have a shoot off between the three who have 12 to see who will join whoever is defeated in that shoot off to go into the bronze medal match. Sounds a bit complicated, but it's just two shoot offs basically. And there's the man who doesn't have to worry about it.
Yeah, he gets the easy job right now. Sit back, relax, and enjoy the show for a little bit.
Enjoy the smile from Todd, the coach. Much better than having that scowl.
Oh, yeah.
You don't want the scowl.
You don't want that nasty look from Todd. That's when you know you messed up. It's nice having Todd out there, though, and especially with the younger guys. He's such a calming presence. He's been there. He's done that. And it helps. It helps having that confidence that he has in you. You can feel it. And good to have a coach that way.
Yeah. It's difficult, isn't it, as a coach, especially with juniors. Is it arm round or carrot or stick? That's what you have to kind of ask.
Off.
So here we go. Kalionen.
Well, broke the pair and put the pressure on. It looks like we have our shoot-off to get into the bronze medal match first.
First, and then we'll see who's going to join them, because we'll have the gold medal match shoot-off as well, and that will sort of go from the bottom upwards with the shoot-offs. Sicotti. Nicely done. And a chance, still a chance for Italy to have two people in these medal matches. Chabret may have something to say about that. These three athletes battling for a place in the bronze medal match. sudden death format, of course.
Up.
Oh, and a miss from Callione, and you could tell, even if you didn't watch the bird, from his reaction.
Very disappointing.
Yep, so if Ciccotti and Sciarre both hit, then Callione will be out. If one of them misses, then we kind of know who's going to be in the bronze medal match. It's just one that can get back to it.
And a dead pair.
Yep. So then, if Sciarre hits, then Callione will be eliminated, and on we go with a two-way shoot-off.
Oh, and he misses the pair.
Oh, it's a double miss for Sciarre. What a disappointment. Well, there you go. It's Ciccotti who has the pleasure of getting himself into the bronze medal match, and Callione and Sciarre. Sciarre with that double miss goes sixth, Callione goes fifth, and now we have another shoot-off between Vassilio and Palmucci, Cyprus against Italy. Now whoever wins this will go into the gold medal match, and whoever falters, now they will go into the bronze medal match. So not a disaster, but not what you want particularly.
Disappointing for the Finland right there. After shooting such a monster qualifying number, to walk away without a chance at a medal, that's tough.
But I'm sure, as your coaches say, you, from failure, you can learn an awful lot.
That's right. You can learn more from failing than you can from winning.
So then, who will be in the gold medal match and who will be in the bronze medal match? That's what we can find out here. Again, sudden death. You saw the format in the bronze medal shoot-off. Ciccotti managed to prevail in. There's Palmucci.
And they go toe-to-toe.
Absolutely. Not the brightest out there at the moment. Will this be a monster shoot-off? Or the conditions just dictate that someone will blink first.
The door's open. Palmucci can break this pair. He'll guarantee himself a medal and chance at a world championship.
And just listen to the crowd if it does happen.
Oh!
A miss as well. On we go. Well, they're all ready to jump up and give her a big hug, as is the Italian way.
Yes, he was.
But sit back down in his seat, the coach, and on we go. Another station. Both missed one then. Still this sudden death format. And well, who can reset, keep themselves calm and collected? Oh. That's another miss.
Another chance here.
Yeah, another chance for Palmucci, the Italian. Well, they're both 18 years of age. The least experienced of the two. And he's done it. Listen to the response of the crowd as well. Well, it's Palmucci who will take on a young one in the gold medal match. That'll come shortly, but first off, we have the small matter of a bronze medal match. And you can see there, really, from our wide shot, that it is getting a little bit dark out there. So there's confirmation. Jungmann and Palmucci will contest the gold. Vassilio and Ciccotti of Italy, rather, will contest the bronze medal match. And that was quite exciting. I mean, who says juniors are every bit as enthralling as the seniors?
Oh yeah, no, without a doubt. And especially at this level, the way these juniors are shooting it's impressive. They can hang toe-to-toe with most of the senior shooters out here.
Which bodes well for the future of the sport, really.
It is. Definitely a bright future, and it's gonna be tough to win in the future. There's a lot of great athletes out there.
So then here we go with the bronze medal match. Christian Ciccotti, the Italian. Both Italians find themselves in medal matches. Ciccotti up against Nicholas Vassilio of Cyprus for that bronze medal. And there's confirmation of how it all lines up. And it's Cicotti of Italy against Vassilio of Cyprus. Cloud rolling over. Palmucci against Jungmann coming up.
Happy coach there knowing that he has one medal and has a chance to get two on the podium. Yeah. Quite an accomplishment for Italy if they can pull that off.
And a very loud national anthem, but a miss straight off for Cicotti. That's a second miss as well. Well, the format the same as for the semi-final, just the two shooters, of course. And that's not the way you want to start. Gives Vassilio all the confidence in the world.
Showed no sign of slowing down there with that pair. Made a perfect move to the front target and broke the pair with ease.
Nicely done from the Cypriot, and that really does put the Italians under a little bit of pressure there. Cypriot coach, nervous as anybody else, of course, still a good turnout here. What is it now, almost 20-7 local time. We've a lot of action here, not just the qualifying, of course, but the men's senior contest, and we're still going here. Getting brighter and brighter, that big scoreboard by
us. Yes, it is.
Goes to an almost all white back. We're bathed in light, and when it doesn't, it's a little bit dark and dingy. The scoreboard facing away from the athletes, luckily for them. Cicotti, looking back into this bronze medal match. That's
much
better.
That was a couple big pair to come back and get right back on track and, you know, put a little pressure on the Cypriot and see what happens.
Stumbled through the semi-final match, really, if truth be told. But here he is. So far, he's soaking up that pressure and giving it back in spades. Nicely done. I wonder if we're going to be in for a marathon bronze medal match at the moment. Suggests that Nicolas Vassilio is not in the mood to give up the advantage that he has at the moment. He's halfway through this match and he's two targets ahead of Cicotti. A long way to go though.
A lot can happen with these final eight targets, especially here in the junior category. You see some crazy stuff. Cicotti is not, he's not backing away from it. Although he's down, he knows he's not out, and he's still fighting with everything he has.
Yeah, the battle is not mentally to be too downhearted. If you have a couple of misses, just keep going. You never know. Nicely done.
And that's a really tough pair. I mean, we've said it with the lighting, but it just keeps getting darker and darker, and It's gonna make that shot harder and harder as the time goes on.
That's that scoreboard, or the screen, anyway, the advertising screen you can see. Bathes us in light when it goes to a white item. Vassilio needs two to keep him two ahead.
Oh, and there's his first miss.
Yeah, one miss. So, not all over just yet. The Italian crowd here, young and old, will be hoping that there is a little bit of life left in this bronze medal match yet.
Cicotti needs these to keep the pressure on Vassilio.
Yeah, needs to shoot these perfectly, these two doubles. Nice start. You all know that Vassilio blinked in the last pair. I wonder if he can do it again. But he needs to get these to put the pressure on. Oh, is that a miss at the end? It is. Oh, that's not great. So, excellent work still from the youngster. But a chance now for Vasilio to add a junior world championship medal to his three European championship medals. Here are these now to make sure. There we go. Level on 13 apiece. Just the one will do. Will he finish this in some style?
There it is.
It's enough. In fact, it's more than enough. Nicely done. Just the one miss from the man from Cyprus. The 18-year-old is the man who will take the bronze medal. And, just missing out. The local fans would have loved him to have been able to go forward. But against Vasilio, who takes the bronze, Christian Sigotti has to settle for fourth place.
Disappointing for Sigotti, but he still gets to sit back and root on his teammate and maybe see his teammate win a world championship right here.
The thing about these medal matches, doesn't take a lot, one way or the other, for things to either go your way or for it to be a bad day at the office.
That's very true.
Vasilio, then, who has the bronze, can sit and relax and enjoy this match between two excellent athletes, Philippe Youngman of the United States, Valerio Palmucci of Italy. Last year as a junior for Youngman, he'll be off into the senior ranks along with yourself. He's now 20 years of age, so next year he'll be 21, and that of course precludes him from the junior ranks.
It does.
Yet more competition for you.
Yeah. Well, he competes with us. I mean, he has missed the traveling as the Open as a senior team by an eyelash so many times, and I mean, a great talent, and he'll be traveling more with us as a senior member soon.
Scene is set here for the last act of this World Championships in Lonato, the gold medal match between Philippe Youngman of the United States and Valerio Palmucci of Italy.
I'm actually surprised to see Philip pulled his glasses off for this. I know the lighting's getting bad, but I don't know if I've ever seen him shoot without glasses.
Yeah, sometimes the glasses can pull out the foreground, so the targets even in dull conditions. And that's another miss from the American.
Well, Todd, very surprised. He said, "You gotta breathe."
You gotta breathe, mate. Let's see what's going to happen with Palmucci. He's still dressed as if it's winter here, you know, which is astonishing. And it's very interesting. He'll take one cartridge out of the lower pocket, one out of the top pocket. He's got a routine, isn't he?
He does. I think he's pulling a little heavier shot load or heavier shot side out of his top pocket.
Ooh, that one, dipped on him, but he certainly didn't get it. Had to shoot very late.
He's trying to shoot a heavier shot, I think, for that longer target, which I can't say is a bad strategy. Targets seem to be pretty hard here, and flash targets, as we're shooting here in this final, are generally a little tougher than our standard targets that we shoot in qualification.
Of course, very strict on cartridge weight. We saw Elena Tkach falling foul in Gapola in the final. Very difficult. There's a certain weight there has to be, and even a fraction of a gram over that and you will be disqualified.
You will be.
So I think most of the teams now are taking the cartridge just to double check and weigh more themselves, and someone's got a great job doing that.
Yeah.
Because there's hundreds, thousands of cartridges being used, of course.
Well, it's an important job for us just to know and go out there as an athlete and know that we don't have to worry about our shell weight, that we're going to be okay regardless of what happens. If we get checked, we'll be just fine.
Better second set of doubles from Youngman and Palmucci. So far, equal to the task.
Nice pair. Palmucci keeps the lead.
Yeah, just by a single target, though, by no means clear. And it's going to stay that way. We've had some very exciting medal matches here today at the Lenato range, the Trap Conca Verde. First built way back in 1982. And they've moved onwards and upwards 12 ranges now.
Whew.
That's a big place. Whoa.
Big place. Oh no.
That's a double miss. No, that just didn't look right from the beginning, did it?
No, I don't know if Phillip's really seeing him good. He's not shooting how he normally does.
That's a big moment for him as well. That's not underestimated. That's not even another miss as well. Well, a big chance for Valerio Palmucci. Todd Graves. Trying to ask what had happened. Well, nothing you can do now but reset and just shoot your last set of doubles.
Like we said, you never know. A lot of things can happen. So he's just got to refocus and get ready to shoot those last two pairs.
That's been a miss for Palmucci, and he misses the second one as well.
It's still within reach there.
Yep.
Crazier things have happened.
Well, we had quite a high quality men's, very high quality men's senior gold medal match with not many misses at all. But this has been actually something we have seen quite a bit. See, the wind is getting up as well. So when the light conditions go down, the wind gets up, it's pushing some targets up, pulling some down. It starts to become a scramble for the line.
It does. It definitely adds a extra level of difficulty. It's a good job by Phillip coming back over and refocusing and getting right back at that pair.
So he finishes really well. And will there be a surprise at the death here? Team USA, lots of those t-shirts around, one to the side of me as well. But this is for the gold and the junior world champion. One of these next two shots, that's all that is required. Say, oh, the wind really has got up all of a sudden.
Yeah, all of a sudden it has really picked up. And
I wonder if there might be bit of rain coming. It doesn't matter, we're just about finished. That will do
it's
it.
It's over, we just needed one.
Just the one needed, just as well, really. We missed the last one. It doesn't matter, though, because it's a home win to the locals' delight, and Valerio Palmucci takes the gold medal and is the junior world champion.
Very impressive shooting by everybody here. Open, juniors, fun to watch.
Yeah, it was really good. And, well, you got a feel for Phillip Jungmann having a chat with Coach Doug Graves, who says, good job. But it just didn't go for him today. And whatever it was, whether it was the light or perhaps a bit of nerves, it's, like you say, he will learn from it and go forward. Really quite dark now. That's our last match of this World Championships. We've certainly enjoyed it. I hope you have as well. And have their moment on the podium, of course, coming up very shortly. But here's confirmation of how it has finished here for this Skeet Men's Junior Championship. Nicholas Vassilio of Cyprus gets the bronze. The United States' Phillip Jungmann gets the silver medal. And not a bad result for him as well, but it is a home win and delight for the Italian. The 18-year-old Valerio Palmucci takes the gold and is the world champion.
It's a big win, getting the win in front of your home crowd. Something he'll always remember.
And of course, he has the podium and the national anthem and all that to go through. I'm sure it'll be something that he'll treasure throughout of what will, I'm sure, be a very, very successful career. That is Valerio Palmucci, and he is the junior world champion.
The bronze medal representing Cyprus goes to Nicholas Vassiliou.
Thank you.
the silver medal representing the United States of America goes to Philip Youngman. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the national anthem of Italy. Ladies and gentlemen, we congratulate the winners of the Steep Men's Junior event. We shall commence with the award ceremony for the Steep Men's Junior team event shortly. Thank you.